Welcome back. Listen, with those introductions, we have been like dancing on this stage already. Oh, yeah. So we're like, we can't stop that music. That intro now, it's like amazing. So first off, shout out. We have tons of shout outs tonight, but shout out to Jackie, who I believe was responsible with Lauren to put that music together. So communications team, bravo. Woo! For our new
communications team.
Exactly, for all the new stuff. Hey, listen, I'm Maggie Mixon, and I'm here to do some math with you.
And I'm Canella Prado, and I think we have figured out that tonight's theme is Bucks. Yay, go Buccaneers. This weekend is the home opener, and I think the Packers might be in for a little bit of a problem. That's what I'm predicting right now.
Hey, there you go.
Go Bucks.
So you guys, right this second, no need to wait for Saturday. The phone lines are open. So guess who's calling? You are calling with any math question you have. It could be on any math topic. We're going to do our show tonight on a special topic that is hopefully something you've seen before and just need a little review with. But on that phone number right there, you can call in 813-840-7260 on any math topic, whatever it is that you're working on this evening. I know I was listening to ratios already being on the phone and things with solving equations and all sorts of stuff. But I'm going to tell you, the teachers are waiting for you to call in. We are here till 7 p.m., so call in with your question and get that taken care of. But we're also on the go. We are online right now, live streaming. So if you notice that you have to go somewhere or you're like, somebody needs to watch, the television for whatever reason, notice that website, mhh.mysdhc.org. We actually have a couple websites that would take you straight to that. It all points to that very same one. If this is an easier one for you to remember, www.mathhomeworkhotline.com. Literally, just spell it all out. That can also get you to the same website. So either way, take us on the go and watch the program because we're getting ready to do our challenge question. So be waiting for that, okay?
Right. So we're going to start with the topic. But on that on-the-go thing, I wanted to let you know that some students have told me that they actually watch our show and join in when they're at their practices. Like they have a break in their practice at dance or at soccer, and they actually bring their tablet and their phone and they take a little time to do homework. That's what we call balance right there.
Brain breaks from your athletics.
That's right. All right, so let's do tonight's topic, please. All right, tonight's topic is operations with fractions. So going to be review for our older students, and our younger students are going to be coming up with that in another unit. So preview for some, review for others, something for everyone here at Math Homework Hotline is what we say.
Exactly. So you guys, when you're watching tonight and we're doing operations with fractions, remember again, if you're just tuning in, call in on that phone line at any time with any question you have. It does not have to be on fractions. But not only do you get your question answered, your teacher also gets points for you calling in, and you get points for your class because we have a special contest. So when we roll our challenge question, if you don't even have a question right now, you're like, you know what? I just want to be able to win, get some points for my school, for my class, for my teacher. That's awesome. But the challenge question is going to have you become another one of our Gemmy Award winners.
Ooh.
So that's what we are calling our student of the week, if you will, or our challenge question winner. So it's going to be our Gemmy Award winner. But as we're getting ready to roll that challenge question on fractions, you get those cameras out because it's going to be quick. The question's going to come up. Canella's going to read it to you. And then it'll be one of those things where it's going to be gone. And the very first person to call in with the answer and be able to explain it to one of our teachers will be our Gemmy Award winner. A winner number two, because we had our very first one last week, and you'll see what that prize looks like.
Are we going to show his picture in a bit?
A little bit, yep.
All right. So tonight's challenge question is, of course, again, about fractions. So let's get that up there. Get your cameras out. Get ready. Take that picture. All right. So the challenge problem is to simplify the expression. Negative 32 over 5 divided by 1 over 8. So negative 32 fifths divided by 1 eighth. So I gave a little hint in there, do you think? A tiny little one. If you listen back to what I said, mm-hmm. I give you a tiny little baby hint. So I'm excited for the kids to call in and win this.
Yes.
So I think this is where we'll show them what they should win.
Yes, exactly.
Okay, so that was brought to us by Mathnasium and EdGems. And so I want to start with, let's just start with some wonderful things they get. They get this fun little canoodle game. It's a 2D and 3D game, and it's pocket size, perfect for host, perfect for hanging out with your buddies. This is new this week. We get this bag, and I don't know, I mean,
all the prizes are going to come
together. All the prizes come together. This is our new Math Homework Hotline bag. I was thinking this would be perfect for gym clothes.
Yes.
Right?
Absolutely.
You need a special bag for that. Okay, and then, of course, the ever popular, everyone wants one, our Math Homework Hotline t-shirt. So this is also what some random callers will get tonight as well, just the t-shirt. Then the water bottle. Yay, we definitely want to stay hydrated this time of year because it is still hot here in Florida. We've got a fun dice that's a squeezy, like a stress squeezy. And it is absolutely, it's a great way to also talk about probability. And when we have the probability week coming up, we'll use him. And then we got a deck of Mathnasium cards. Great to play Integer Wars when we have Integer Week. We'll show you how to do that too. And then some great pens and pencils from EdGems. A wonderful post-it notes. Never have enough post-it notes. And then from Mathnasium, they are offering a free certificate to get a free diagnostic assessment. This is where you can discover your strengths and weaknesses. And then they'll build a custom program for you if you want. And that's absolutely free. And there are 7 locations throughout the city. I don't care where you live. You live within 10 or 15 minutes of one of these. And then finally, we're going to talk about the Gemmy. So here is the Gemmy. Now, when it comes to you, it will have your name in here. Okay, so if you win the challenge question, you win all this stuff and the Gemmy. And I mean, this is a sturdy, significant prize. So that is the, and it will have your name. And that's super
cool. School's name, too.
And your school's name. That's right. So good for everyone.
There you guys, go. Last week, our very first Gemmy Award winner was Arush at Walker IB. So Walker Middle Magnet IB World. I was going to make sure I got that right. If we could roll his picture so you could see him and his math teacher with the principal. So there I am. I'm going to go from left to right. Myself, Arush, Principal Holloway, Mr. Nestor, our math teacher, and then from, I was going to say Mathnasium. Mathnasium and EdGems are proud sponsors, but from EdGems came Jessie, so you see her there in the yellow as well. The teacher was so excited that he wanted to put on his shirt for Do the Math. But then while I was at Walker, we got to spot in and see the wonderful, the lovely Miss Canella, Miss Prado's picture. So we got a chance to see
her. I am.
So there we were on our way to see the winner. So Jesse and myself being able to say, hey, we're doing the math all over town. So that was our very first award winner. Very excited to see that. And then you guys also, again, we're having this contest. It's a September contest. Canella is also in the lead for that contest because for the 3 shows in September, whatever teacher has the highest participation is going to win one of our Gemmy Awards. And again, with that plaque, with it personalized with the name and the name of the school. So that's really exciting. All right. So right now, I believe we already have a caller on the line. Is that correct? Is this Kevin?
Yes.
Hey, Kevin. Are you ready to do a question with Miss Prado? She has the very first question already set up for you. Or do you have a question of your own?
I have a question of my own.
Okay, then I'll do that with you my board is wiped clean just for that. All right, let's do it. All right, Kevin, what is your question, sir?
12 divided by 3 times 2 minus 2 is the power of 3.
Okay, so I got 12 divided by 3 times 2 minus, and that's where I dropped off. I couldn't hear what you were saying after that, sir. Do you see my screen? 12 divided by 3 times 2. What am I missing over here?
2
is
the power of 3.
So 2 to the power of 3?
Yes.
Okay, so I have 12 over 3, so 12 divided by 3, times 2 minus 2 to the power of 3. All right, so first thing I think about is order of operations. Is that what you were thinking about?
Yes.
All right, so some people will call it PEMDAS or GEMDAS, like the GEMMY Awards, GEMDAS.
Yay.
Okay, so this is for grouping or for parentheses, and then the rest of it is the same. So when I see, you know, grouping symbols, I mean, I could consider the division as a grouping symbol, but for right now, I'm just going to treat that as a division. I see a multiply, I see a subtract, and I see a power. So I'm going to say, can we start with the exponent?
Yes.
Okay, so if I have 2 to the power of 3, that means what?
It would be 8.
Exactly, 2 times 2 times 2, which is 8. So I took care of that power, and the exponent went away. So I'm following my order of operations, and you were so on top of things. You started right there, got the answer of 8. Now what should we do?
12 divided by 3.
Exactly. What is 12 divided by 3?
12 divided by 3 is 4.
You got it. Hot on fire. And this is where some of our friends, Kevin, will get confused because they're like, why did you divide instead of multiply? Do you want to tell them why?
It's because you have to do the division first because it's in the front.
Exactly. Exactly. So you multiply and divide at the same time from left to right. So multiply, some kids will say, I got to multiply everything first and then come back and divide. And you knew that that wasn't going to trick you. So good job, sir. We're almost done with this problem. Look at how easy you're making it look. Okay, what's next?
4 times 2.
4 times 2. And what number is that?
8 is 8.
Very nice. And I have 8, take away 8. And now my very last step. If I have 8 and I take 8 away, how many do I have?
0.
And I don't know if your teacher ever does this, but to me it always looks kind of funny. It looks like a little pizza slice, right? Maybe a misshaped pizza slice, but it goes from a really long problem to one specific number. So the answer was 0. You did so great, Kevin.
Or a bucks pendant.
A Bucks pendant, yes. Yeah. This is an upside-down pennant, you know, that they have for cheering on the Bucks or any sports team.
That's right.
Go do math. Yay. Thank you, Kevin.
Go math.
Thank you so much for calling in.
Okay.
Do we have another caller?
I think we do.
I believe we do, from Ms. Prado's class.
Okay, so...
is this Lionel?
Yeah, it's. I think it's Leo. Oh, Leia. Oh, Leo. I'm sorry, is it Leo?
Yes.
Okay, it's Leo. Okay. So your question is, can you get this one, Maggie, since my board
yes,
is already?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, so I'm going to read it while you're writing. It
yes,
says,
ma'am.
Leo is asking, if Jenna had 9 cookies that took 20 minutes, how long does it take to bake? Is it 19, Leo? 9?
Yeah.
9? Okay, so we're talking about 9 cookies in 20 minutes. And then we want to know, how long is it going to take to make 19? So what are you thinking of using to solve this? I can think of 2 things right off the bat. One would be, I think, a little easier. So what do you think, Leo? What do you think you'd like to do to solve this?
Cross proportion.
Yes.
Okay, good job. I agree. A proportion is the way I'd go, too. All right, so Maggie, are you ready to go?
I have that for you. You said Leo, right?
Leo, uh-huh.
All right, Leo, you ready to look at my board? We're about to put it on for
you.
There
you go.
And you said proportion. Talk to me a little bit about proportions, because some of our friends may not remember proportions. What do you want to work with? How are you going to set this up?
So, 9 over 20.
9 over 20. All right. So you're doing basically the number of cookies to the amount of time or minutes that it takes to bake, right? So 9
yeah.
cookies is... going to be baked in, or they're going to be baked in 20 minutes. So I'm going to make that equal another fraction or another ratio, if you will. And what is it that you're going to put on the other side to make that be the same setup, if you will?
And the numerator, you're going to put
19. Beautiful. And what are you going to put for the denominator?
X.
Very nice. And just for consistency's sake, I'm going to do this on the other side so everybody sees that you did exactly what you said you were going to do, cookies to minutes. So both sides, both fractions represent the number of cookies at the top and the number of minutes at the bottom. Now that we have a proportion set up, you guys, it has an equal sign in between them. We have a couple of different methods that kids like to use to be able to solve a proportion. How do you like to solve that?
I would like to use
the butterfly method?
Yes.
All right, so what is 9 times x?
9.
9x, beautiful thing. And then what is the 19 times 20?
390.
Is it 390 or 380?
380.
Okay, I just wanted to double check. We check each other, see? That's what good mathematicians do. All right, so now that I have the diagonals multiplied, if you will, 9 times x, 20 times 19, now I have to do what to figure out what the answer is?
Divide
by
9.
Yes. 80. So divide by 9 on both sides. So I'm trying to isolate the variable, because basically what I'm saying is 9 times something is 380. And we know that multiplication and division are inverse operations. So if I divide 380 by 9, it should give me that number that I'm looking for, right? That mystery number. So
yes.
How do you like to divide normally? Are you using your calculator, or are you going to do this longhand with me?
Longhand?
All right, let's do it. I'm going to do it over here underneath my Bucks pennant. So 9 goes into 3 how many times?
0.
So 9 goes into 38 how many times?
4.
All right, so 4 times 9 is 36. I'm helping you out there, so good job. So I brought down the 2 and then the 0, so 20. 9 goes into 20 how many times?
Twice.
Beautiful. 9 times 2?
Is 18.
18. Beautiful. And I get a 2 for my remainder, which is really interesting, because what's going to happen is if I keep adding zeros, like if I put my decimal and I add another 0 and bring another 0 down, I'm going to keep getting 20. So at this point, it looks like to me like I'm going to have a repeating 2 if I want to leave it as a decimal and I put my little bar notation. But you know what we can do actually? Let's just stay right there without adding a decimal. And do you remember that because I have a remainder of 2, I could write it as 2 over 9? So 42 and 2 ninths of a minutes, I should say. So it's a fractional number of minutes. So I could say 42 and 2 ninths or 42.2 repeating, and I'm going to write it with the bar notation. For some kids, it's easier to make it look like a decimal. But honestly, either of the two answers would have been correct, all right? Unless they have you rounding to a specific number. What do you think about that?
Yeah.
And I'm going to tell you, this to me also looks reasonable, right? Because we wanted to take a look. If it was 9 cookies in 20 minutes, we not only did we double that, but we went an extra cookie more, right? So now I'm looking at doubling the 40 plus a little bit more. So that to me, I always check for reasonableness as well. Are you okay with our answer?
Yeah.
Very nice. And don't forget your units of minutes. Thank you so much for calling in today.
Awesome job, Leo.
Good job, Leo.
Thank you.
Yay, look at all these great mathematicians.
Fractions are everywhere,
yes.
Right? Even we had to use fractions to solve that proportion, and then the answer could be written in fraction form. So I'm going to take a step back, and we're going to talk about modeling, okay? So, we're going to have a friend with us, it looks like.
Ooh.
Is this Abigail? Hello, Abigail?
Yeah.
Abigail. Hi, Abigail. How are you today?
Good.
Okay, we're going to do something fun with modeling for our visual learners. Are you ready to give it a try?
Yeah.
All right, thank you. All right, so we're talking about which model matches 2/3 times 1/2. And we have A, B, C, and D. So I think the easiest way to figure out which one matches is to make our own, learn so that we can learn how it is. And then once we make our own, we'll see which one it matches. So this is going to be our own down here at the bottom. Hopefully you can see that by now. So, okay, so we know that the first fraction is 2/3, right? So that's why I drew this into this box into thirds. See how I drew 1, 2, 3? Long rectangles. So I know that I can color 2/3 of them. I can color 2/3 of them. And then I'm going to color the other half. So to make it half, this one's good this way. Vertical is going to be thirds and horizontal is going to be half. See how I drew this into thirds and then a half? So right away, we can kind of eliminate a couple of choices, can't we? Because two of these boxes don't look like this one, do they?
Yeah.
Can you tell which ones look different? Like this one only has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rectangles in it, correct? Which ones have more than six up here, A, B, C, and D? Can you see that? Can you see that B has 9?
Yes.
Okay, so it's not B, right? Okay,
how? Yeah.
And what other one has 9? That would be not right. Does C have 9? Yes, you got it. There you go. Perfect. All right, so we're down to two answers. So let's start coloring him to figure out which model he is. Are you kind of getting a hint already? Maybe?
Yeah.
All right, so I'm going to color 2/3 of it. So remember, our thirds are vertical, right? So I'm going to do, this would be 1/3, and this would be the 2/3. So 2/3 of it now are green. I'm going to go a little darker because this green's kind of light, okay? Now, I'm going to switch colors just so that it's easy to see. And I'm going to go with purple. And I'm going to color 1/2 of it. So the 1/2 will be horizontal, understand? So we're going to color this top half purple. Okay?
Okay.
See that? All right. So do you think that our model looks like one of these two models here, A or D?
Yes.
Which one?
A.
Correct. Now I'm going to discuss with you why this works, okay? Can you see on A and R's that these two sections, I'm going to color them in black here, have both red and blue in them, or purple and green? See that? Those two had both. So what it's meaning, what it's trying to tell you is that 2 out of 6, okay, 2 out of 6 would be the answer. So let's check if that's right. When we have fractions and we're multiplying across, we just multiply them across. So what's 2 times 1, Abigail?
2.
And what's 3 times 2?
6.
So did we get 2 6 that had both colors?
Yes.
Yes. Now, I'm going to push you a little further, Abigail, because you are sharp today. You are on top of this. Can we stop here, or is there something wrong with that fraction? Can we go one step further with that fraction and do something that starts with an S?
Ooh. Yes, you can.
Yep. We can. What can we take it to? 2 6 can be simplified to what? If we divide both top and bottom by 2, what do we end up with?
1/3.
Yes. Because 2/6 is in fact 1/3 simplified. You did amazing with a good concept there. I'm very proud of you, Abigail. Good job.
And guess what we have on the line? Our challenge winner.
Do we have
winner.
The challenge winner?
Yay! We have our Jimmy Award winner. Is this Anisha?
Anish.
Okay. Oh, hey, Anish. You are calling from Williams?
Yes, Williams Middle Magnet School.
That is awesome. You know, we've had some rivalry between Williams and Walker.
So, a little bit.
Yeah, I know. My teacher told me.
Yeah, exactly. So Ms. Hunt's going to be super happy. All right, I saw how you worked out the problem, and it looks good, but let's let our viewers get your thinking. So I wrote on my board the question, the challenge question. It's kind of like off to the side. And then I wrote the way you started solving it. So talk us through, how did you know that that meant division?
Could you repeat that, please?
Yes. How did you know that the problem, the original way that it was written, meant that to divide?
I remember my teacher telling me that that for -30, that for fraction bars, you have to always have to do division. And I also recognized the hint where you have to, where she was saying out loud, divided.
Very good. I'm laughing at Canella over here because
I
she gave you a hint.
And
it's the challenge question.
I know.
All right. So you divide the first fraction of 32 over 5. Make sure that's negative by 1/8. All right. Talk me through the rest of that, please.
So after that, I turned the -32 and the 5 into fractions. So negative 32 over 1.
Okay.
Divided by 5 over 1. And then I have to change it into multiplication. So I flipped over the 5 over 1 and turned it into 1/5.
Okay.
And I did negative 32 times 1, mm-hmm. which is negative 32, and 1 times 5, which is 5. So after that, I did I turned 8 into, I took 1/8 and divided it by negative 32 over 5. And mm-hmm. similarly, I would do, I would put the 1/8 over and turn it into 8 over 1,
mm-hmm.
and negative 32 times 8 was negative 256, and 5 times 1 is 5. And then I just did the division for that and got negative 51.2.
Very nice. Now, I had a question for you, because I had not heard somebody explain it that way before. When you took, like, here the fraction, when you actually split it up even further, could I have asked from the very beginning, could we have done it like this, negative 32 over 5, just multiplied by the reciprocal, and gotten the same thing? So
Yeah, you could have done that.
Exactly. You went through a number of steps that I encourage you. I mean, if that's the way that you remember how to do that, I'm just going to want to save you a little bit of time, if you will. If you could just leave that first fraction the same, and then you're saying just times the reciprocal. Remember, the reciprocal, we just invert, you know, that second
yeah.
fraction. That's going to save you a number of steps and sometimes, you know, mental exhaustion, if you will. But I commend you. You did that so beautifully, and you are our Gemmy Award yeah. winner. So you will be getting this plaque to be taking a picture with this week, and then you'll get your very own one that will have your name as well as William's name on that. So we're so excited that you called in. I'm going to tell you, this is so fun that you guys are able to win all these prizes, right? Congratulations one more time. And you guys, we have some extra t-shirt winners. So not only our Gemmy Award winner, but Canela has now some t-shirt winners for calling in.
Yay! All right.
Yay!
Yes. Okay. So our t-shirt winners thus far this evening are Derek from Williams. We have a Williams thing going on here.
There you
and
go.
And Abigail, not the Abigail from earlier, but the Abigail from
Mulrennan. Yes.
And Isabella from Maniscalco. All right. Enjoy.
Yay, Isabella.
Those t-shirts will be in the mail to you, and you will get them soon. Awesome
yes,
job,
will.
Guys. Thanks for calling in.
All right, so t-shirt winners, challenge winners, Gemmy winners, all sorts of winners.
Winners, winners, chicken dinners.
But guess what, you guys? We have a gem for Ed Gems. We wanted to play for you just real quick. Our gem, and if that's ready to roll, there is an extra little hint that we want to give you from our sponsor.
All right.
All right, so the gem for tonight has to deal with, there you go,
the target tracker.
So guys, for the target tracker, this is a resource designed to enable students to visualize expectations. Notice that they look like thermometers. So for every lesson in that unit, you're gonna have basically a way for you to check your progress. But this is for you, the student. So it should be in your print version of your workbook, and teachers can assign that for you to be able to self-assess, which is a beautiful thing. Self-assess means you just check your own understanding. See where you're at, gauge yourself. Am I getting this? You know, what's my temperature? The higher your temperature, the better you feel about this particular topic. But that's a good way for you to set goals for the unit, reflect on your skills, definitely be tracking your progress. And there's a place at the bottom for you to be able to write still, like, what are some things you can do to practice, or some of your misconceptions, and just maybe some of your challenges, and then you can share that with your teacher. You can share this with your family. But the biggest thing is for you to see for yourself as you're going mm-hmm. through the unit, this target tracker. Remind you that it is in digital form. So when you go to your EdGems book online, it's there. And you can see how it's being filled out. You see where the arrow is on that screen. Or it's also in that print version, and you just kind of shade it in. All right.
Yes, I'm a big fan of a goal-oriented classroom. An individual goal is everything. I have my kids actually write on their test what their goal score is, and you wouldn't believe how excited they are when they hit that goal. I mean, it is jump for joy time. So those target trackers from EdGems is perfect for that. So I have a caller, and her name is Kimberly. Hello, Kimberly. Hi, Kim. Hi. Let's do a multiplication problem with fractions, okay? This is going to be fun. I feel like you're going to be amazing at this. Let's get it. Let's go to the board, please. All right, Kimberly, we have a question here. It says, what is the value of 2 3/4 times 3 2/3? And we need to multiply these two fractions. These fractions are called a mixed number, right?
Yeah.
So do you remember what's the first thing we have to do? Take a good guess. What do we have to do first before we can start multiplying across? What can we do?
You have to make it
into an improper fraction, which is great. And I like to say this. I like to come up with fun names. I call it the Ferris wheel method. Okay? So you take the denominator, you multiply it by the whole number, and then you add the numerator. Okay? So if I did that, if I took the denominator, multiplied by the whole number, and added the numerator, what would we get here? 4 times 2 plus 3.
You would get 11.
11, and what would the, what, 11 fourths, that's correct. Now let's go ahead and Ferris wheel the second mixed number. What would we get?
You would get 11 over 3.
11 over 3, because 3 times 3 is 9, plus 2 is 11. And then you just keep the denominator the same. And the reason they call it the Ferris wheel is like when you're, I call it the Ferris wheel, is when you get on the Ferris wheel, you get on the bottom, right? And you go around to the top like that. That's how it happens. So that's how I call it the Ferris wheel. It's, you know, kind of looks like a Ferris wheel. Plus Ferris wheels, let's face it, are just plain fun.
Yeah, they are fun.
All right, Kimberly. So now we've got two improper fractions, and we're going to multiply them. So you just multiply across the numerators and then multiply across the denominators. So what's 11 times 11, Kimberly?
11 times
11.
11. 121.
Perfect.
Yes.
And what is 4 times 3?
12.
Okay.
Nice.
So then I'm going to just do a tiny little review of my, you know, any chance I get to sing, I'm going to. So I always tell the kids, you type it into a calculator, or how you write it is 121 divided by 12. So the 121 goes in the house to speak, and the 12 is on the outside. So how many times does 12 go into 1? No times, right? But how many times does 12 go into 12, Kimberly?
12 goes into 12 one time.
All right, nice. So I have to sing my little song. Divide, multiply, and subtract. Bring it on down and bring it on back. So we're going to take what we divided. 12 divided by 12 is 1. Then we multiply. 1 times 12 is 12. Subtract. And then bring it on down means bring down the next number. And then bring it on back means let's do it all again. So how many times will 12 go into 1?
12 goes into 1.
It'll go in no.
What? 12.
It goes in no times, right?
Zero times.
So 12 times 0 would be 0, and then you're left over with the 1. So then what you're going to do then is, let's see, should we just make it into a fraction form?
Yes.
Okay. So then to make the remainder into a fraction form, we put the remainder in the numerator, and then we just bring the divisor into the denominator, and we are done.
Ta-da!
La la!
So and that makes sense, because 12 times 10 is 120 with
right?
A little bit left over.
There's some common sense here going on. Kimberly, you did an outstanding job. I couldn't be more proud of you. Thank you for calling. Good job.
And hey, not Kimberly. Only did she get to do her question, you got to sing. Hey!
I'll sing again. Don't try to stop me.
Don't ask me to sing, guys. That's not going to happen because you don't want to hear that. All right, so we have Vidu?
Vidun, I believe.
Vidun? Hey, Vidun, I have a question just for you. Are you ready?
Yes.
All right, let's do this. I have the magical question of what is equivalent to 1/4. Now, this is a multi-select, so it could be that all three, only two of them, you're not sure which two, or maybe just one of them. Typically, though, if it's a multi-select, you have at least a couple. So we're going to try to figure out which of these fractions, and we're multiplying all the way, so we're doing the same operation, but which one of them is going to give us an answer of 1/4? You ready to hit that challenge with me?
Yes.
All right, so let's do it. So my first choice, 1/2 times 5/10. What would you do when you see something like that?
I would multiply.
Okay. So what do you...
numbers.
All right, what do you multiply?
The numerator to the denominator.
All right, so numerator times numerator. I got 1 times 5 is 5. 2 times 10 is 20. All right. Now, the magical question is 5/20 the same as 1/4?
Yes, because if you divide both by 4, the numerator is 1 and the denominator is 4.
Very nice. So you said if you were to divide that by 5, right?
5, yes.
So divided by 5. So it actually should have been on this side. I'm going to do that so I don't make it look like bad math. Okay, so there you go. So... very nice. So it sounds like A checked out, but we can't stop there, right? What are we going to do now for B? 1/3 times 4/5. You want to use the same method? Multiply across the top, multiply across the bottom?
Yes.
All right. 1 times 4?
4.
And 3 times 5?
15.
Now the question is that equal to 1 over 4?
No,
absolutely not. And I know it took you a second to look at it, which I am so proud of you for just kind of pausing and saying, wait a minute. When you pause for a second, what were you looking to see? Like, how did you know that these are not equal, the 4/15 and the 1/4?
In order to get 1/4, you have to be able to divide the numerator by itself, so you get 1, and then the number that you divide it by
right. You are so awesome at this. Good job. I love that explanation. All right, so let's finish up here with letter C. 3 times 2?
6.
And 8 times 3?
24.
Beautiful. The question again is that equal to 1 over 4?
Yes.
How did you know?
Because I divided 6 by 6, get 1, and then 24 divided by 6 is 4.
Very nice. So 1/4 equals 1/4. I love it, love it, love it. Good job. That was amazing work for us, and you are going to be so amazing at this in your class. I just know that. Congratulations, and thank you for calling in.
That was a total touchdown for Vadoon.
Touchdown.
Touchdown. All right. We have another caller. Is this Camille?
Yes.
Hi, Camille. How do you feel about dividing some fractions tonight?
He's pumped.
I think so. Let's go for it. Let's just hit the board and do it. Let's
go. Field goal.
All right. So the question is, what is the value of 1/6 divided by 2/3? Now, Camille, you know I like to sing on this show, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the good, I know it's going to happen whether we want it to or not. All right. So there is, I'm going to give a shout out to Number Rock because I stole this song from them.
Oh yeah.
So, and they sing and much better than me, but they sing to divide by a fraction. Here's a tip, keep, change, flip. So we're going to keep, change, flip. Kind of looks like KFC only a little bit backwards, but that's what I say. To divide by a fraction. Here's a tip, keep, change, flip. I know. The Grammys are calling me. Never.
You don't need a Demi or an Emmy. You
no,
need a
no,
Grammy.
I'm going to get a Grammy and wait till the art teacher sees some of my artwork.
Yes.
Okay. All right. So we're going to keep the 1/6. Okay. Camille, what do you think we're going to change it to? What do you think we're going to change it from division to what do you think?
Multiplication.
You got it. That's right. So we're going to multiply. A dot also means to multiply. And I want to like reinforce that. Okay, and then we're gonna flip. So what do you think's gonna happen to 2/3 if we're gonna flip it?
2/3 over
3
over 2.
So 3 over 2.
It's the reciprocal. Reciprocal just doesn't sound as good. Keep, change, reciprocal.
Yep,
no, it just doesn't work
as well.
All right, so now we just multiply across and then we'll have one left step left to do. So what's 1 times 3, Camille?
That's 3.
And what's 6 times 2, Camille?
12.
All right. And are we done? What do you think? Could we do anything else to this fraction? Can we maybe Can we maybe
simplify?
Simplify. Music to our ears.
Woo! All right. So what does 312 simplify to? It simplifies to 1/4 because they both have a factor of 3. So the greatest common factor is 3. So you divide by 3, divide by 3, and you would get 1/4 as your complete, total, and final answer. Another winning attempt here on Math Homework Hotline. I am so proud of you, Camille. Great job. Thank you for calling in.
That would have gone with our other question, too, of the ones that were equivalent to 1/4. That would have been another one of those
questions that was
equal to 1/4. All right, you guys, we have another caller on the line, we believe, and this is, tell us who you are.
Arian.
I am Arian.
Hey, Arian, in Ms. Prieto's class?
Yes.
Yay, we are excited because you're going to get to work on a Tom Brady question with me, okay?
Okay.
All right, I'll give you a hint. We're going to go to the board, and you're going to see a lot of writing, but there's some numbers in there that we're going to dissect out and figure out what we're going to do with them. All right, here we go. Tom connected 4/5 of his passes. Aaron connected 5/8 of the passes Tom made. What fraction of connected passes did Aaron make? So they're trying to figure out Aaron, who doesn't seem to be quite as great as Tom here, but what are we going to do to figure out how many, what fraction of the connected passes did Aaron make? I'm going to give you a hint. There's a 4/5. There's a 5/8, and then there's another hint right here of the passes. What do you think we're going to do? Actually, it says the word fraction. So if we know Tom Brady connects 4/5 of his passes, right? It says that Aaron connects a part of those, not all of them, okay? So a certain percentage or a certain fraction, which is given to us as a fraction here, is 5/8. So we're trying to figure out, think of it like this. Have you ever said or been to a store and it says like 20% off or 20% discount or something like that? Like there's a sale going on? Okay. So think of it like that, but we're going to look at it in the form of a fraction. All right. So here the total was 4/5. So we're trying to do 5/8 of 4/5, all right? The word of is a real big giant clue because this is going to tell us what operation we're going to use. So Tom Brady connects 4/5, but this guy Aaron connects 5/8 of these 4/5. Does that make sense the way I set it up so far?
Yeah.
Okay, super. What do you believe, and I'm going to give you some choices here. What do you believe, what operation goes with the word of? Is it add, subtract, multiply, or divide?
Multiply.
You got it. You sounded like you were hesitating a little bit, but that sounds perfect. 5/8 times 4/5. And literally, this is how I write it out at first with the word of. And then I help myself, you know, with the tool. I just took that out of the problem. Then I start thinking, what do I know about this word of? So I'm going to multiply. Now all I have to do is multiply 5/8 times 4/5. Do you know a shortcut way of doing that, or do you multiply across the numerators and then across the denominators?
I mean, you can just do 4 times. Oh, wait.
What is it?
I remember, like...
Yes.
You could, like, make numbers smaller by...
Yes. So cross cancel. I love, 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 because not every kid knows that, and it makes life so much easier, right? So right now, if anybody was tempted to say 5 times 4 and then 8 times 5, they would have gotten these really big numbers, right? But then they would have still had to simplify further, and that would divide by 20, divide by 20, and I would have had 1/2. If you were going to cross cancel, can you show our friends how you would have done that? I'm going to put this off over here to the side, okay? So if you all you were given is this fraction, 5/8 times 4/5, and I said go ahead and cross cancel to make the numbers a little bit smaller so you could deal with smaller numbers, what would you normally do?
So you would divide
mm-hmm.
into 5 1.
Exactly.
Become 1.
Exactly. And then what happens with the 8 and the 4?
4 goes into 8 twice.
Exactly. And then 4 goes into 4 once, right? So now I'm left with 1 times 1 and 2 times 1. And isn't that the exact same answer than if I would have multiplied all the way across and then simplified?
Yes.
Exactly. I love cross-cancel because to me, it makes the problem a lot easier with the smaller numbers, right? I'm just going to put here the word cross-cancel in case anybody is taking a look at that. Hey, congratulations, Arian. That was amazing work. Thank you so much for calling in.
Good job, Arian.
We have some t-shirts.
All right. We have some t-shirt winners. Let's see them. Where are they?
There they are. Uh-oh.
Okay, well, this is what they're going to win. We're looking for the list of names. But it is this beautiful Math Homework Hotline t-shirt that will be
sporting
soon mailed to your school for you to receive. We still don't have the winners' names yet. But
we have 3 winners coming up, though.
3 winners?
Yeah.
All right. We love winners here.
We love winners.
Giving stuff away here, too.
Absolutely.
Love it. And a lot of the schools will allow you to wear this on Spirit Day if you're a uniform school. So in my school, I see them donned. And if I catch a kid that's wearing them in the hall, I sometimes offer a little incentive, a little wolf coin.
PBIS?
Little PBIS, teachers. A little PBIS goes a long way. So
positive reward system.
That's right.
Guys.
Positive behavior incentive system.
There you go.
So, all right. Well, I think we're going to have to come back to the winners because we don't have the name yet.
That's okay. We're always ready for math.
So I've got another problem like Maggie's, but I want to show you a tip.
Ooh.
Okay. Wait. We have a caller maybe. Do we have a caller? Hello, caller.
Who are we talking to?
Hello.
Hi. Who is this?
Deanna.
Hey.
DL? Okay.
I think it's Tiana.
Okay. All right. So we have on my board, we have another one of these word problems with fractions. Okay.
Gianna.
Oh, Gianna. Hi, Gianna.
Yes.
Okay. All right. So Mike ate 7/8 of an energy bar before practice. Julio ate 2/3 of what Mike ate. That doesn't mean he ate his leftovers. That means he ate 2/3 of the 7/8.
Yes.
What fraction did Julio eat of his bar? So one of the things that I like to teach kids to do is I like to teach them when they see like what I consider to be hard numbers, decimals, fractions, ones that you are less comfortable with, put in something simpler, like 8 and he ate 1/2. And then if I said he ate 1/2 of 8, Gianna, would you know what half of 8 is?
4.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
So really what you did is you took 8 times 1/2, and then you can substitute in the real numbers. So 7/8 times 2/3. See how easy it makes it when you just put in some, numbers
friendly.
You're more comfortable with, right?
Yeah, friendly numbers.
Friendly numbers, and then you substitute in, because it was 8 times 1/2, so now it's 7/8 times 2/3. Now we're going to simply multiply across. So, what's 7 times 2, Gianna?
14.
And what's 8 times 3, Miss Gianna?
24.
Yay! Now, are we done, or can we do something more to this fraction to make it even better? Can we simplify? Yeah. So what do you think they both divide by? Well, 2. That's right. Because 14 only has the factors of 1, 14, 2, and 7. So we're going to go with 2. Okay. So what's 14 divided by 2, Gianna?
7.
And 24 divided by 2?
12.
And now you're fully simplified.
Yay.
This is a prime number and it doesn't, divide into 12. So there you go. Yay. Good job, Gianna. Way to go. Okay, we have the winners. Yay, winners. All right, here we are. Again, beautiful t-shirt winners again. And we have Landon.
From York.
From York. And we have, oh, another Yaslin from Mulrennan again. Woo-hoo! And Owen from Rogers.
Yay! That is that neck of the woods. Most of those schools are in the same area.
And shout out to our friend Stephanie there.
Yes, absolutely.
That's
Ms. Jamel.
Speaking of shout outs, we probably should do some.
And speaking of shout outs, we have Mathnasium, who is definitely on our woo-woo awesome list. And let's show that slide. I'm going to tell you, Mathnasium is so on fire for you guys. If you notice there, Mathnasium probably supports Math Homework Hotline. And guys, we make math a priority this school year. We discover why over a million parents have trusted Mathnasium to trust their children's math skills and build their confidence. So you definitely have these live face-to-face instruction that is offered both in-center and online. Go ahead and call for your free assessment. Schedule that in any one of those locations that you see there. Brandon, Carrollwood, Lutz, New Tampa, Riverview, South Tampa, as well as West Chase. So they are so happy and eager to see you. Every time I've been into one of the locations, super friendly staff. Somebody's always there just with a big old smile, ready to do some math with you.
That's
and
right.
And guess who's still on the line? Sophia.
It looks like we have Sophia. Hello, Sophia.
Sophia, we're getting ready to divide some mixed numbers. You ready?
Yes.
All right, let's do this. I got 3 1/5 being divided by 6 2/5. Tell me, where would you start?
Can you repeat that, please?
Yes. I have 3 1/5 being divided by 6 2/5.
6 2/5?
6 2/5, yes. So if I have a mixed number, what is it that we want to do with these first?
You have to times the bottom number.
All right, so multiply and then add. So you're going to turn these into an improper fraction? Or
yes.
Some people will call them a fracture greater than 1. All right, 3 times 5?
15.
Add 1?
16.
16, and what am I going to put as my denominator?
5.
So all we did, guys, is we took what 3 wholes is really... what it's really going to look like 15/5, and then we just added an extra 1. So if you think of it as common denominators and so forth, so that's what we were doing. So it became a 16/5, right? Now, what are we going to do with this 6 2/5?
We're going to also do the same as the other.
Same as the other. So we multiply the denominator in this whole number, and then we add that numerator. So 5 times 6?
30.
Add the 2.
32.
So same idea where we said, hey, this whole number, if I had to make it look like not a whole pizza, but a pizza that was cut into 5 slices, I would have had 30/5, right? And then added those extra 2 slices, so it was 32/5. All right, so we got those mixed numbers to look like improper fractions, so we're ready to start dividing. Now, what do we normally do with a division problem?
I can't see your screen.
It's okay. 16/5 is being divided by 32/5. So when we divide a fraction, do we normally say divide or keep?
We say, here's a tip, keep, change, flip.
Keep, change to a multiply.
Change. And then?
And then flip it. So we're going to multiply by the reciprocal, right? So I didn't learn a cool song like you guys do in class, but I always remember multiply by the reciprocal. So whenever we divide a fraction, we just multiply by the reciprocal, which just means the inverted fraction, okay? So let's see. We have 16/5 times 5/32. Do you like to cross-cancel like we did in an earlier question, or do you like to multiply all the way across the top and all the way across the bottom?
Cross-cancel.
I'm going to tell you that is the best bet for this question because it's so nicely set up. All right, so what I see for cross-canceling, the 5s go into each other. So 5 divided by 5 is 1. Now, the 16 and the 32, talk to me about that. How does that cross-cancel?
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
It's okay. If I have 16 and I have 32 and I'm trying to get them to be a smaller number, what do they both divide by?
2.
Do you have another number that's a little bit bigger than that?
How about a lot?
4. All right. I can say keep going.
You could keep going, but we could do 4.
We could do 4. So 16 divided by 4, 32 divided by 4, and then I got those smaller numbers. I would have actually taken it a step further and multiply or divided by 16, but that's a really, really big number, all right? So now I have 4 times 1, and then I have 1 times 8, and I went ahead and I did that multiplication, but now I have 4 over 8, and I got to keep checking always my fraction. Can I simplify it or reduce it even further?
Yes.
What can you reduce this by?
4.
So definitely 4. So again, another common factor, 4 divided by 4 and 8 divided by 4, and I have an answer of 1/2. And these were all positive numbers, so we like positive numbers.
We like positivity.
It looks
here.
Very nice and beautiful. Sophia, thank you for your work and demonstrating all that you know.
Good job, Sophia. So I promised some shout outs this week.
Yes.
Did you promise some?
Yes.
I wanted to get these in there really quick. Number one, my amazing hat. Thank you, Colson. That's amazing. And then if we could go to the big screen, we've got a jersey from Giada in front. And down below me, Camille, who actually called in tonight, gave us this beautiful flag.
Very nice.
Below you is a wonderful poster from Zavi. So lots of good stuff. And you had some shout outs as well, right?
I did. I just wanted to shout out to Daniel and Kevin, who are watching tonight, and they were doing some extra good math this week. Now, they're a little younger than some of our callers. They're in first and third grade, but they were doing all sorts of great math, being able to solve word problems and regrouping and using a number line to skip count, you know, and so forth, and adding, guys, remember your basic steps sometimes, even when you're doing two-digit numbers being added together, right? So shout out to Daniel and to Kevin, and I just wanted to say congratulations to Zane, also at Steinbrenner, for doing some amazing work out there and being part of our homecoming corps.
Oh, yay, Zane. All right, I have a really quick problem. If we can go to my board,
yes.
I think we can squeeze her in.
Just do the math.
Okay. All right, Sienna uses 1/8 a cup of cherry syrup and has 2 cups of syrup. She wants to make, she's obviously having a football party here.
Yes.
She wants to make them. She's trying to figure out, well, how many can she make?
Mm-hmm.
So what, if it was like, if she had 8 and they each took 4, we would go 8 divided by 4 equals 2.
Right.
So we're going to take our total. Her total is 2 cups. And then she's going to divide it by each, which is 1/8.
Oh.
And then we're going to keep, change, flip.
Keep, change,
and remember,
flip.
2 is really 2 over 1.
Yes.
And then we're going to multiply, and then 8 over 1.
Because we flipped it.
And then we're going to do 2 times 8 is 16 over 1, which simplifies to just 16. She's going to have a nice amount of cherry Cokes there for her little football watching party. Good job. So there you go.
That is. That's a lot of
We squeezed
football.
In one more. I'm so proud of us. Yay.
You guys stay tuned for next week. Remember, this was show number 2 of September. Show number 3 is going to be next Thursday. So we are definitely 3 shows in a row for September. That means that our teacher winner will be determined next week. But who has the highest number of calls for those 3 September shows? But that won't be actually announced until the following show. So you got all those all that time to get everybody excited and going.
Keep calling.
Just keep calling.
Come on, Ms. Hunt. Get those kids to call me. Let's go.
Ratios and rates is our next topic. And we're going to have a Tampa Bay Rays theme. So I'm just going to let you know it's going to be a radiant night.
And we're going to knock it out of the park.
Home
runs left and right.
Right now we got touchdowns all the way.
That's right. So home opener this weekend. I'm excited. I think it's going to be a big one.
I'm going to be in Tallahassee for our Noles, so go Noles for family weekend.
Aw, that's great.
You got
your
watch.
Last family weekend for a little
Saturday
while,
at 8 o'clock. Go Noles. All right. Talk soon, guys. Do the math. We'll see you around town.